Ben Affleck has proven to be a fantastic filmmaker, and in many ways, his decision to direct has influenced the quality of his acting as well. Gone Baby Gone, The Town, and Argo are all very good movies, and this new era in Affleck's career has been a study in momentum. His return to grace has been a joy to watch, and Live by Night is his most ambitious film, a sprawling crime epic Affleck wrote, produced, directed, and stars in. The film is based on a Dennis Lehane book and tells the story of a stick-up man who rises to power during Prohibition and the two loves of his life. Live by Night boasts an insanely rich pedigree. Cinematographer Robert Richardson, who has made the works of Scorsese, Stone, and Tarantino shine, is on board. The best of Hollywood is on hand to make the film look great, sound great, and the cast is peppered with a nice array of familiar faces and really strong performers. But sadly, it's one of those almost films. You can see the great film bubbling under the surface of Live by Night. It's a film that aspires to be an epic, chronicling a generation of crime and redemption, but it doesn't linger long enough on anything to fully take root. It's like Ridley Scott's Kingdom of Heaven, a film that was greatly enhanced and improved by the release of a director's cut on home video, but one that wasn't able to find the right balance in its theatrical cut. And it's a shame, because the story is quite interesting. Affleck plays a man who is caught in the middle of a gang feud and is forced to take a side when the woman he loves, it's always a woman in gangster films, falls prey to one of them. Relocated to Ybor City in Florida to work in the rum trade during Prohibition, he finds his groove and becomes a pretty big deal. He spars with the local government, other crime bosses, and even the KKK, all the while struggling to maintain his soul in a business rife with violence and mayhem. Affleck as a director has shown a strong ability with the medium, and he shoots action and violence in a way that is both old school and surprisingly fresh. There are some really interesting action beats. He also seems to enjoy the period setting. If nothing else, Live by Night is a beautiful movie, and though Affleck's creative reach may sometimes exceed his grasp, there are plenty of moments that shine. He also wisely lets his cast do what they do best. Elle Fanning is terrific as a corrupted young woman who corrects course with dangerous side effects. Chris Messina is a revelation as Affleck's savvy right-hand man. Remo Girone, who looks like the Italian Michael Gambon, is fantastic as the Italian crime boss Affleck works for. Sienna Miller completely immerses herself in the role of an Irish immigrant gal caught in the middle, and Zoe Saldana grounds the film with a vital warmth amidst all this hardship. Affleck himself is subdued here, almost too much so, though there are moments where his charm surfaces and makes the audience wish for more of that levity. But it's simply too much material, and nothing is given enough air to breathe. The era of the epic crime story in cinema seems to be a dying one, with most of these stories going to television to live fuller lives. It's not a big failure, though it'll almost definitely be a commercial flop, but it's a case where more time in the editing room could have made a big difference. There's a great movie here, just sadly not on the screen. It's an almost. For a January release, it's acceptable, but the reality is Warner Brothers and Affleck would have truly benefited from delaying the film in order to carve it into shape. Unless, of course, this is the best it could have been, but that's unlikely. Here's hoping Affleck isn't discouraged by this, because it's only a minor hiccup in the grand scheme. But regardless, it's hard to recommend it simply on what it may have been. The product as it stands is a fun diversion, but it's quite shy of the crime classic it was intended to be.